Hello everyone, let us start our discussion with the histology of cartilages. The cartilages are classified as the specialized connective tissues, and just like any other connective tissue, cartilages also have all the three ingredients, that is the ground substance, presence of fibers and cells. So like any other cartilages, any other connective tissue, they do have ground substance, fibers and cells present inside. The cartilages are broadly divided in three types. We have three types of cartilages, that is hyaline cartilage, elastic cartilage and fibro cartilage. So there is hyaline cartilage, elastic cartilage and fibro cartilage. Now what is common to all these three cartilage is the presence of chondrocyte. Now there is a presence of chondrocyte Chondrocytes are present in all the three types of cartilage. So how do we differentiate them? The differentiation between all these cartilages is based on the type and amount of fibers present inside. Type and amount of fiber present inside will decide that what type of cartilage is that, whether it is hyaline, elastic or fibrocartilage. We also should know about the cartilage that they are avascular, they are devoid of blood vessels. So if they are avascular, then how they are getting their nutrition? The nutrition to the cartilages are coming from the perichondrium of the cartilage, which is actually richly supplied by the blood vessel. So roughly if I say this is the perichondrium here. So this is the perichondrium part, and let's say this is all ground substance here. This is all ground substance, and there we have chondrocytes present in the ground substance. Now these are chondrocytes, let's say perichondrium, and this is ground substance. The perichondrium is richly supplied by the blood vessels. So the blood vessels which are present in the perichondrium, they will supply these chondrocytes via diffusion through the ground substance. They will supply the chondrocytes via diffusion. And we must also note that the fibrocartilage are the only cartilages which are devoid of perichondrium. So let us begin our discussion with the hyaline cartilages. Hyaline cartilages are the most abundant type of cartilage in the human body. Regarding the location of hyaline cartilage, the hyaline cartilages are located in the fetal skeleton, they are present at the articular end of the bone, so articular cartilages are hyaline only, present in nose. Coastal cartilages trachea, bronchi, larynx, and even epiphyseal plate. Epiphyseal plate, which are nothing but the growth plate of a young bone, they are also having the hyaline cartilages. Now, as we know, for any cartilage, there are three components. We have fibers, ground substance, and the cells. So let us start with the fibers of the hyaline cartilage first. In the ground substance of hyaline cartilage, the most dominantly found collagen fiber is type 2. So type 2 collagen fibers are present predominantly in the hyaline cartilages, and these type 2 collagen fibers, they are around 15 to 40 nanometer in diameter. As we know, the collagen fibers are the one which provides the strength and stability to the cartilage. And it is also to be noted that these type 2 collagen fibers, or the collagen fibers which are present in hyaline cartilage, they are not seen in the histological section. The reason they are not seen in the histological section, because of the same refractive index. Because they have the same refractive index as that of ground substance. The ground substance and the collagen fibers, they have the same refractive index. So in normal HNE preparation, we cannot appreciate the collagen fibers in it. Apart from type 2 collagen fiber, hyaline cartilage also possesses type 6, type 9, type 10, and type 11 type of collagen fibers as well. But all these collagen fibers, that is 6, 9, 10, and 11, they are present only in very small amount. They are present only in small amount. Coming to the ground substance, the ground substance of hyaline cartilage is featureless. That is, it is homogeneous ground substance. Which stains blue, stains intense blue. With the basic dye, that is hematoxylin. The main component of the ground substance is the sulfated proteoglycans. Sulfated proteoglycan, which is also called as aggregans. Aggregans. So this is the main component of the ground substance in the hyaline cartilage. The basophilia of the matrix, this intense blue color of the matrix, there is a basophilia of the matrix is mainly due to the presence of these two components, that is chondroitin sulfate. Chondroitin and keratin sulfate. Chondroitin and keratin sulfate. They are the ones which are responsible for that intense blue color because of their acidic nature. And if you look at the lacuna here, now let's say this is a lacuna. Now let's say these are the lacunas here, and we have these chondrocytes which are present inside. Now what you will see, there is a high concentration of all those chondroitin and the keratin sulfate around these lacunae. And this is called as the territorial matrix. This is referred as the territorial matrix. Whereas as you go away from this matrix, when you go away from the matrix, the concentration of this sulfated proteoglycan will become less and less. And because of this less proteoglycan, that intense blue staining will not be seen in between the lacunae. And that region will be called as the interterritorial matrix. That is called as interterritorial matrix. So you see this intense blue staining around the lacuna only, because of more amount of sulfated proteoglycan present in there. And as you move away from it, that region is interterritorial matrix, which is not that intensely stained as like around the lacuna. About the cells of the hyaline cartilage, there is only one type of cell present inside, and that is chondrocytes. And these cells, they occupy the lacuna in the matrix. Now, let's say this is the lacuna here. And we have these chondrocytes which are present inside the lacuna. What you can also appreciate here that all these chondrocytes are shrunken in the HNE preparation. In HNE preparation, the cells are shrunken, and that's why you see a gap. That's why this gap is seen between the lacuna and the cell margin. You can see this gap here. So that's the reason for the gap between the lacuna margin and the cell. The chondrocytes, these chondrocytes, this is obviously the lacuna here, and these are the chondrocytes inside the lacuna. These chondrocytes are responsible for the synthesis of the collagen fibers, and also the ground substance. The collagen fiber and ground substance are synthesized by the chondrocytes only. The group of the daughter cells from the chondrocyte, they remain in the close relationship and they form this thing which is called as a cell nest. So it is one cell nest you are looking at. As I said, the group of the daughter cells from this one chondrocyte only, they will divide by mitosis and they will stay in close approximation to each other, and this thing is called as a cell nest. Coming to the perichondrium of the hyaline cartilage, as you already said that the hyaline cartilage, they are covered with the perichondrium. So they are covered with the perichondrium, but this perichondrium is absent at the site where the cartilage forms the free surface. At the free surface, like in joint cavities, there is an articular cartilage we are talking about, but we do not have perichondrium in the region of the joint cavity where they form articular cartilage. And also the place where they make a direct contact with the bone, like coastal cartilages, and even epiphyseal plate. So we do not have perichondrium in the hyaline cartilage, which are present in these regions, the joint cavity, the costal cartilages, and the epiphyseal plate. Well, perichondrium is having two layers. So we have a outer fibrous layer and then we have this inner cellular layer, also called as the inner chondrogenic layer. The outer fibrous layer is having these dense irregular fibrous connective tissue. So outer fibrous layer is having the dense irregular fibrous connective tissue, whereas on the other hand this inner cellular layer is having the presence of the cell which may convert to chondrocyte. When cartilage is growing, so inner cellular layer is having the presence of cell which may convert to the chondrocyte when the cartilage is growing. It should also be noted that in adult cartilages, only fibrous layer is present. Only fibrous layer is present in case of the adult cartilage. So there is no chondrogenic layer or there is no inner cellular layer present in case of the adult cartilages. Well, the hyaline cartilage, they display both appositional and interstitial growth. The hyaline cartilage, they display both appositional growth and the interstitial growth. When you say appositional growth, that means we're talking about the addition of a new cartilage at its surface, that is appositional growth. And when you say interstitial growth is about the new cortex is formed, the new cartilage is formed within the existing cartilage by dividing and the differentiation of the chondrocytes which are present inside. So new cartilages is formed within the existing cartilage by dividing and differentiation of the chondrocytes present inside. Well, this is the histological section of the hyaline cartilage. As you can see in this, this is a section taken from the trachea. Now let me focus to this perichondrium region here. As we know, perichondrium can be divided in two parts. We have this outer fibrous layer. This outer fibrous layer, it is having this type 1 collagen fibers on the outer surface of the perichondrium. You can also appreciate the blood vessels which are present inside this fibrous layer, the outer fibrous layer. Whereas the inner layer or the inner cellular layer, also called as the inner chondrogenic layer, where you can see the fibroblast like cells which can differentiate into chondroblast and initiate the matrix production, and they become immature chondrocytes later on. Looking at the chondrocytes in the hyaline cartilage, now that's the feature of the hyaline cartilage. If you look at this, the cells within the lacuna inside the cartilage, they occur either as a singly or they are present in the cell nest. Now you can see all these cell nests present here, and we have the chondrocytes present inside them. If you look at the matrix which is present around these cell nests or these chondrocytes, so we have this territorial matrix which is basophilic area, which is this intense blue color which you can appreciate around the chondrocytes. Whereas the matrix which is present between these isogenous group, this is called as the interterritorial matrix, which is less intensely stained area because of the isogenous between the isogenous groups of the chondrocytes.
Well, after hyaline cartilage, let's now talk about the elastic cartilage. Starting with the location first. Location of elastic cartilage is pinna. You can find the elastic cartilage in pinna. Epiglottis. Elastic cartilage are also seen in the apex of arytenoid cartilage. Even corniculate and cuneiform cartilage are also elastic. External auditory meatus as well as the auditory tube. So these are all examples of the elastic cartilage. They are all location of elastic cartilage. Well, as the name suggests, the elastic cartilage, they are named as elastic cartilage because of the highly elastic in nature. And in the fresh section, they look yellow. They look yellow in fresh section. And that is why they are also known as, because of their yellow color in the fresh specimen, they are also called as yellow elastic cartilages. They are also referred as yellow elastic cartilages. Regarding the fibers in the elastic cartilage, well, obviously we call it elastic cartilage because we have elastic fibers inside. So they have these branching and anastomosing. Branching and anastomosing elastic fibers present in. And these elastic fibers, they are heavily concentrated in the center near the perichondrium. They are heavily concentrated in the center of the cartilage. Elastic fibers are actually not seen clearly in H&E staining. They're not very clearly seen in H&E staining. So that's why we use a special stain to visualize these elastic fibers, and that special stain is Orsin stain. It's a special stain with which we can visualize these elastic fibers very clearly. Well, nothing much to discuss in the ground substance as well, because the ground substance of the elastic cartilage is just like hyaline cartilage only, and it contains proteoglycans. We already talked about it in the hyaline cartilage. So the ground substance of the elastic cartilage is just like the hyaline cartilage only. Coming to these cells, chondrocytes are present in lacuna only. But the thing is, the chondrocytes which are present in elastic cartilage, they are way bigger than the one which were in hyaline cartilage. So they are bigger than the cells of hyaline cartilage. These chondrocytes, they are either present in the lacuna as singly, or maybe in group of two. Unlike the hyaline cartilage, where we can have 3, 4, or 5 chondrocytes present in one lacuna and forming the cell nest. So they're usually present singly or maybe in the group of two. And it is also to be noted that the cells are closely placed, and that is why the intercellular ground substance is much lesser than the one which we saw in the hyaline cartilage. So cells are closely packed. And that's why the intercellular ground substance is much lesser than hyaline cartilage. So it's more like this. If this is the chondrocyte, so we have these chondrocytes present in the lacuna. We have a larger chondrocyte, as we said. And they're usually present singly or maybe the group of two. And then we have these elastic fibers which are running in between them. Same chondrocytes in the lacuna, and you can see the elastic fibers. These are, let's say, the elastic fibers. And these are chondrocytes in lacuna. Perichondrium, the perichondrium is also just like the hyaline cartilage. So we already talked about the perichondrium of hyaline cartilage. The perichondrium of the elastic cartilage is also just like the hyaline cartilage. It is same as hyaline cartilage. So that is about the elastic cartilage. Well, this is the section of epiglottis to talk about the elastic cartilage. If you look at closely to the perichondrium of these elastic cartilage. Now again, perichondrium, just like hyaline cartilage, is divided in two parts. Now we have this outer fibrous layer which is present. This is the outer fibrous layer. And then we have this inner cellular layer or the inner chondrogenic layer, which you can see just beneath the fibrous layer. Chondrocytes which are present inside, the cells within the lacuna inside the cartilage, they may occur as a single cell or they can be as a cluster of two cells as an isogenous group. And unlike chondrocytes of the hyaline cartilage, they are quite larger in size. Whereas the matrix, if you look at the matrix part here, we have all these randomly placed elastic fibers in between all these large chondrocyte cells. Although in HNE staining, it's a bit difficult to differentiate the elastic fibers. The streak of pink within the matrix are due to the presence of elastic fiber. The streak of pink that you see inside all these, that is all because of the elastic fibers, all this that you see in between, all this. But as I said, we cannot clearly appreciate the elastic fibers in the HNE preparation. And coming to the last one, that is fibrocartilage. The fibrocartilage, which is also called as the white fibrocartilage, and is having the abundance of thick collagen fibers. Well, histologically, these fibrocartilage, they resembles dense regular connective tissue. They resembles dense regular connective tissue, and because they resemble the dense regular connective tissue, so one may confuse the section of fibrocartilage with the section of the tendon. So you got to be very careful when you're looking at the slide of fibrocartilage and try to look for the chondrocytes which are present in between these collagen fibers. So the slide of the fibrocartilage and the tendon, it looks almost the same because both are having this dense regular connective tissue, but the presence of the chondrocyte will help you differentiating these two. Regarding the location of fibrocartilage is in the annulus fibrosus of intervertebral disc. They're also seen in the pubic symphysis. In manubrious sternal joint. Seen in the menisci of knee joint. Also seen in the articular disc. Also seen in the articular disc of the temporomandibular joint and sternoclavicular joint. And this fibrocartilages are also seen in the glenoidal and acetabular labrum as well. Glenoidal and acetabular labrum. So this is about the location of the fibrocartilage, the usual site of the presence of fibrocartilage. Coming to the fibers of fibrocartilage. Well, as we said, we have thick collagen fiber present inside. So the type of collagen that you will see in the fibrocartilage is type 1 as well as type 2. So type 1 and type 2 collagen fibers, both are seen in the fibrocartilage. And the proportion of the type 1 and type 2 collagen fiber, it varies with the different type of cartilages. It varies with the different type of cartilages. In case of intervertebral disc, now intervertebral disc is one good example here where we have the type 1 and type 2 collagen fiber present in equal proportion. So in the annulus fibrosus of the intervertebral disc, type 1 and type 2 collagen fibers are present in equal proportion. The ground substance for the fibrocartilage, it is having the minimal basophilic substance. So there is a minimal basophilic substance around chondrocytes like in hyaline cartilage. About the cells of the fibrocartilage, now there are, first of all, there are very few chondrocytes. Very few chondrocytes which are present. And the chondrocytes which are present, their orientation is between the bundles of collagen fibers. So they are oriented between collagen bundles. They can be oriented in row or they can be scattered singly also. I mean, if like this is the fibrocartilage, these are the collagen fiber bundle we have. and between these collagen fiber bundle, the chondrocytes are present, and they're present in row, maybe singly or maybe in row. So number of the chondrocytes are comparatively way less than the one which will present in elastic cartilage or in hyaline cartilage. And the unique thing about the arrangement is because of these thick collagen fiber bundle, they are scattered in row. And as we already discussed this earlier, that perichondrium is absent in case of the fibrocartilage. So fibrocartilage, they do not have perichondrium like we had in elastic cartilage and in hyaline cartilage. Well, this is a slide for the fibrocartilage. You can see that there is no perichondrium present on either side of the fibrocartilage. Looking at the arrangement of collagen fibers, you can see these are thick collagen fibers which are arranged in the parallel bundles. You know, collagen fibers do not branch, but there is a bundle branching of collagen fibers. And you can see all these thick collagen fibers which are present in this cartilage here. You can see the chondrocytes which are present either as a single. So we have the singly placed chondrocytes inside the fibrocartilage, or the chondrocytes are present in the columns, or the chondrocytes in a row. Look at this row here. This is a row of the chondrocytes. They can be present in the isogenous group as well. In this region, you can see they are present as an isogenous group. And looking at the matrix of the fibrocartilage, we already know that matrix of fibrocartilage is having much less material surrounding the chondrocytes as we compare it to the hyaline cartilage, where it is a lot of matrix around the chondrocytes. You already know that we have this type 1 and type 2 collagen fibers which are surrounding them. And the basophilia is due to the high content of the sulfated glycosaminoglycans that are present in the fibrocartilage.